Hello everyone, hi, it's been a while since I've done one of these. Also, happy 2020. I hope you've all been having a wonderful 2020 so far, despite all the things that happened in the world. Anyway though, how are you all guys doing? Another Pokemon video for you all, as you can probably tell. The reason that I'm making this one though is, as I am recording this, I just watched the new Pokemon Direct that just launched, and oh my god, there's so much I want to talk about! Oh, there's so many new things. I was just expecting it to be an update on Pokemon Home and Sleep, which are coming out in February 2020, by the way. Well, Pokemon Home's coming out in February 2020. Pokemon Home is a way that people can, you know, transfer Pokemon from different games to the newer games that they're in, and vice versa. It's so cool. But I gotta talk about these next things, honestly. You know, we're gonna be talking about all the new stuff that's coming out, the new games, the new stuff coming to Pokemon Sword and Shield. Everything that works. I think we should all be really hyped. I'm really hyped. I need to calm down a second. Okay. Well, where to begin? The first thing that was obviously revealed, the first thing that was shown, was that Pokemon Mystery Dungeon Rescue Team is being remastered. Yes, the first iteration of the Pokemon Mystery Dungeon games are coming to the Switch, remastered, brand new artwork. It looks amazing. I'm a huge fan of the old school Mystery Dungeon games. Explorers of Time, Dawn and Sky are my favorite ones out of all, but I super love Red and Blue. I super can't wait for it. Oh my god. This is something that I wasn't expecting. I thought maybe, but it wasn't in my prediction. This direct blew my mind. The artwork is not fantastic. It looks like it's a combine of both games, basically. So rather than doing two separate ones, just doing one big remaster for both of them. I am super looking forward to it. Seriously. I've been frantically tweeting and I've been frantically doing everything. I just can't stop myself. I've been like just messaging everyone, telling everyone everything. Ah, I super can't wait. That's coming out in Twitter on the 6th of March 2020. So only 2 months away. I know what I'm getting in March. I'm getting like, there's 3 games out that I want in March. Oh god, I'm gonna be broke by March. In the panic coming in. In the panic. In the panic. Oh, that was the first big thing. That's only the first thing too. The next thing is that for the first time ever, something that I've been wanting Pokemon do for a while because it would be so cool to see, Pokemon Sword and Shield are getting expansion passes and are getting DLC content. Yes, this is absolutely true. Not a joke. Absolutely not no fake news or anything like that. It is literally happening. It is coming later this year. The first one coming out in June of 2020. The second one later on in 2020. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm just so hyped. I am so freaking... Oh. I need to calm down a second. I need to calm down a second. Oh my god. Right, so the first expansion that's coming out is called the Isles of Armor. It's coming out in June 2020. It features new rivals, Clara and Avery. One is equipped with a sword, one is equipped with a shield. And then the next thing, and then also it's going to be introducing new Pokemon. New G-Max Pokemon will be coming. Blastoise and Venusaur going to starters get a G-Max Pokemon. And these expansions are going to add 200 more Pokemon that are already in the Pokedex to the Pokedex as well. Not to mention Galarian Slowpoke. Ugh. Words are hard. Words are hard when you're hyped. Words are really hard when you're hyped about a Pokemon game. Oh my god. But yeah, it will also feature a new mentor, which was actually a mentor of Leon called Mustard. Yeah, bit of a weird name, but hey, new mentor that could teach us the ways and all. It looks like we're gonna be exploring the Isles and maybe doing some kind of trial or something. From the looks of the rivals, are aiming to make their own gym. Clara is a poison type gym, a poison type trainer, and Avery is a psychic type trainer. Basically, both of them will be your rivals that you encounter. There's also going to be new clothing items, There is going to be new forms for your bikes. The theme of the Isle of Armor is apparently on growth, which will be interesting to explore. There will also be a new Pokemon, a new legendary, which, give me a second, which has like a evolutionary chain as well. Its first one was Kubfu. Kubfu is so adorable. Like, it's so cute. I definitely am into it for sure. I definitely want this Pokemon for sure. It'll be the new legendary that you can acquire. And this legendary can actually evolve as well into Urshifu, which has two separate forms. They didn't say if the forms are going to be exclusive to the different games. So there's a method where you can do where you can evolve it. One will be a fight in a dark type, one will be a fight in a water type. Unsure still about how you get them. They also have G-Max forms as well, which is really, really freaking cool. Like, G-Max Urshifu is going to be awesome in competitive and going to be awesome just in battles in general. There's so much we got to... I mean, I was expecting to just shiny hunt until the next one comes out. But now we're getting expansions. We got more content coming. We got more content coming to the Pokemon games. I'm so looking forward to. Oh my god, you have no idea. I mean, you can just tell from me, just like frantically talking about all the games. I'm sorry. If you're wondering why I'm looking this way, by the way, I'm literally looking at my other monitor of all the information that is here. Yes, another thing that's going to be happening as well is that Galarian Slowpoke is coming to the Pokemon games as well. It's a new Galarian form, something which is going to be interesting to see and obviously enjoy and everything. The second DLC that's coming out, from what I can gather, is coming out later this year. Is going to be called, what's it called? Brain Bart. Crown of Tundra? The Crown Tundra. The Crown Tundra. That's the one. The Crown Tundra. As you can see, I didn't really prepare for this at all. I just kind of went into frantic rant. The Crown Tundra will include a new legendary, known as... where's it gone? Where's the new legendary name gone? I had it written down somewhere. Clyrax. The new legendary. Psychic and Grass type. Apparently, it ruled over that part of the Galar region in ancient times. New legendary Pokemon. Also, there is going to be co-op in this legendary, in this new area as well, which features a brand new area. But yeah, both game expansions have brand new areas as well, which you can explore. Which I forgot to mention, because I'm an idiot. And the new areas, especially the second one, the Crown Tundra, will have co-op play where you can literally encounter legendaries. All the legendaries, well, we're not just talking about some of them, all the legendaries you can encounter throughout throughout all of the Pokemon games will be on there. And you will be able to capture some new forms of legendaries. There are Galarian forms of Moltres, Articuno, Zapdos. And the Regis are coming back. And not only that, there are brand new Regis forms as well. They look awesome. I super can't wait for them to get here. I really want to get this now. But we're going to have to wait until later in the year. But 2020 is already looking so good. It's already looking so good, chat. Also, apparently the same storyline for the Crown Tundra is that you're all part of an exploration team. You'll become the team leader of an exploration team exploring these ruins. All of these new legendaries and all these new... kind of features and new everything. Oh, I super want these games, honestly. Yes. And as I said, the Isle of Armor is coming in June of 2020. The Crown Tundra is coming in fall of 2020, so later in the year. I am definitely picking up pre-ordering the expansions whenever I get the chance to. Probably next payday. I super can't wait. Might put up a goal for it as well, which I'll see. We shall see. More news as well from Pokemon 2. More news and everything, which I may have forgot to mention or anything like that. There are going to be some new G-Max forms coming later today, later on as well. G-Max Colossal, G-Max Lapras, and G-Max Appleton will all be available later on the same day which I'm recording this. You'll be able to find them in the Max Raid areas. I will probably begin work on doing that myself, for sure, after I'm done with my latest shiny hunt, because I'm currently shining out for a Grookey. I'll let you all know what happens with that. I might end again. We'll see. Yes. So they're all coming later today as well. And I think that might be everything. Pokemon Home of Iron Mission is coming out in February 2020. All these new freaking, all this freaking news, all like, all this freaking news has got me so riled up and everything like that. I can't wait for it. Oh. Seriously, I mean, I've been wanting Pokemon to do DLC content for a while because I feel like it would improve their chances of making new games. Because, like, them doing DLC content now, they're planning on releasing it throughout this year. They could end up doing more as well, giving them more time to work on the next title and potentially even let us go to different regions. Right, at this moment, the Isle of Armor and the Crown Tundra are different new areas in the Galar region itself. But these DLCs could open a window to go into different regions. If they were to do that, I would lose it. I've been wanting to do something like this for a while, doing DLC content. And now we are getting it. And I am super pumped. I cannot wait. I am going to be getting these as soon as I possibly can. I mean, as soon as like the news came out, I immediately just wanted to record a video on this. Because we've done Pokemon Talk in the past, Pokemon News related to Sword and Shield and everything. Haven't done one for a while since the release of the games. But I just had to immediately pick up and where we left off and before and do that. And oh my god. You know. So yeah, what to expect at the moment? Galarian Slowpoke and the G-Max, new G-Max forms Pokemon are coming later on in the same day as I'm recording this. And you can also encounter the expansion rivals as well. You can encounter them in, I believe, the G-Max area, the Max Raid area in the train station, if I recall. And you can also encounter Galarian Slowpoke as well. That'll be appearing as a update as well to the game. Pokemon Home is being released in February 2020, so you'll be able to trade Pokemon via that new system. And Pokemon Mystery Dungeon Remaster is coming in the 6th of March 2020. Pokemon, first expansion for Pokemon Sword and Shield is coming out in June of 2020, and that's the Isle of Armor. And the Crown Tundra, which is the next DLC after that, will be coming out in fall of 2020. All catch up there on there. All new things are coming. I super can't wait for it. I hope you all didn't get sick of me ranting on about all this or getting too fanboyish or anything. I am very sorry. Also, sorry if you saw me scrolling through things or anything. I just wanted to find the information really quickly. I'm probably going to go calm down now, as I really need to calm down because my mind is just like everywhere right now. I need to absorb all this information. And probably I'll even stream later on today as well. No idea when this video goes up, but if anyone has watched this and enjoyed this video, feel free to give it a like. Subscribe for more content as more becoming, more shiny reactions, more Pokemon highlights. And of course, more videos like this, where potentially I may show off my Pokemon teams, Pokemon Sword and Shield. Little tease, potentially. We shall see. Feel free to comment down below as well. Let me know what you think of all the latest Pokemon news. Have a wonderful day. Thank you all for watching, and I shall see you all in the next video. Bye, everyone. Bye. God damn, my brain is on fire.